your fuck. Got on Facebook, and the first thing I saw, Confederate flag. Do I get involved? As I read the comments, the main thing that I notice, this is my heritage is most the poster's focus. Heritage, heritage, what is this word? I basically knew, but I still went ahead and searched. In this context, it's inherited history, a cultural connection to the past, which is interesting. Heritage is important, I understand this desire. I want to hear legends of ancestors by the fire, but the Confederacy fell in 1865, founded in 1861, so let's divide the 4 years it stood with the length of time America has existed. When you do this, you will find 1.64%. That's what it represents. It existed for half a minute, dude. It just came and went. So really, how could this flag be emblematic of your lineage, history, the intricacy of your fabric? It's almost done a disservice to focus on such a morsel. Wouldn't you want to live with a historical picture that's more full? Where's your family from? Ireland? Italy? Furthermore, the funny thing is, where do you stop with history? The oldest human ancestors' bones have been dated to 7 million years, which is way before the cave shit. I could break it down, but basically, to keep it brief, the species migrated from Africa to the northern east, Tigris and Euphrates region, then the rest of Earth. Before culture could emerge, tech had to develop first, like writing, agriculture, such a big deal. Maybe I'm crazy, but shit, dude, I just feel to identify your heritage with 2% of history is a limited vision. Consider different centuries, let alone millennia. The further back you go, your idea of heritage will more massively grow. So, anyway, if you still think it's tricky, check the Declaration of Secession written by Mississippi. It says they identify with the institution of slavery. These are their official words. Maybe we should listen to the Confederate commander who spoke out against Southern monuments, never said the answer was to tamper with historical standards. But when hammers get slammed against something that stands for slavery, then manners is a funny thing to predicate your argument upon. Plus, history isn't taught with monuments I'm on. Empty with my patience, yet I long for real discussion. I don't want hateful exchange, I just cannot see the function of this flag. I'm from Texas, trust me, I'm no liberal. In fact, I find the Democratic establishment quite pitiful. Fuck 'em. I'm just saying the states have documented moments where they say they wanted slaves. I've provided a work cited in the comments below. To say that's not what it's about is just dishonest. So help me out and please be consistent. Don't pretend you're preserving history, then become resistant when hit with facts. Yes, the Germans have monuments to victims, not perpetrators of intolerance. I'm not opposed to memorials or historical markers, but a Stonewall statue where slaves worked is garbage. Participate in the debate, no snowflake emotion. I'm coming at this with my mind, and make no mistake, it's open. Convince me, cite your work, I'm fucking here. Let's talk about it calmly, no waiting another year. I'm not calling you racist or disrespecting your views. I'm saying make a logical case, because frankly, I'm confused. In the early 1900s, the United Daughters of the Confederacy successfully waged a propaganda campaign not only to erect numerous Confederate statues, but also to change the curriculum taught in public schools. So if you're a voice who advocates for the preservation of history, but you don't know about the UDC, you should probably check that out.